Well, hello, ladies. It's so good to talk to you today. The question that was posed to me was, what does Christmas mean to me? And as I thought about that, I thought about, well, before I became a Christian, well, you know, Christmas was, the decorations were great, and, you know, there was lots of shopping, lots of busyness. But mainly, I wanted to know where the next Christmas party was. And, you know, I kind of knew that that baby in the manger was Jesus, but that's about as far as it went. But then when I got saved and I began to read the Word of God, oh my goodness, that baby in the manger was miraculous. And the thing that really impressed me so much too was the prophecies, all of the prophecies regarding not only his birth, but his life, his death, his resurrection. But I'd like to talk about the prophecies regarding his birth. In Isaiah 7:14, it says that this the Messiah that the Jewish people have been waiting for over 400 years, the Messiah would be born of a virgin, and that his name would be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Is that amazing? God with us, the creator of the universe with us. And then it goes on to say in Micah 5:2 that this Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. Now, I knew about the trip that Mary and Joseph made on the donkey to Bethlehem, but I never thought, why? Why would they do that? Because God used a pagan king to call a census that every person must return to the place of their birth. Well, lo and behold, Joseph, Jesus' stepfather, was born in Bethlehem. So they had to make the trip to Bethlehem, and Jesus was born in Bethlehem. How beautiful was that, born of a virgin. And it also, I think about the shepherds in the fields, how God used the lowliest of people to not only see a multitude of heavenly hosts proclaiming glory to God in the highest, but they got to see the Messiah. They immediately went to Bethlehem because they knew something miraculous had happened. All these things came together because of God's prophecy. Now these prophecies I'm talking about were written by Old Testament men 700 years before all this came to be. And there are so many prophecies regarding the life of Jesus that we simply don't have time for today, but I just wanted to give you a couple regarding his birth. And then I also think about the lineage of Jesus, because to the Jewish people, so important that they come from which tribe. It has to be, you know, in the royal line. Well, it just so happens that in Matthew chapter 1, he begins the genealogy beginning with Abraham, all the way through to Joseph, Jesus' stepfather. And that is the royal line. Then with Mary, if you remember the angel Gabriel, when he came to her and she said, how can I give birth when I've never known a man? And he said, you will, the birth will be of the Holy Spirit, and he shall be on from the throne of David. That's the bloodline. That's how God made everything come together for us to believe that this baby in the manger was the Savior of the world, that this baby in the manger came to give us life eternally, that this baby in the manger came to tell us of the kingdom of God and us his love. So today, when I think about Christmas, I think how important it is that during this busy, busy time of the season, that I take time to remember all these amazing things about Jesus. That I take time to remember that he willingly gave his life for me. That I take time to remember he is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I'm so very, very thankful that that little baby in the manger came to be with us, to give us life eternally. And that's what Christmas means to me.